Very good day to everyone. I am back on teachosm.org. Today I want to start to end of mapping a certain area. So I'm logged in and let's start mapping. I have created a task for a taluka in the Chandrapur district in near Gadchiroli in Vidarbha region of Maharashtra. So I'm going to just search for talukas. And yeah, Pombhurna is the name of the taluka. Let's go into the task. So this is the interface of the tasking manager at TeachOSM. We have the taluka marked out here, and if you zoom out, you can see where, like, in relation where it is. And it's near Chandrapur over here. If we zoom in, then we can see that it's a nice quaint countryside. There's a few roads marked, not much done. Bing imagery helps us look around at places. So here the purpose of this task is to mark roads connecting different places to the existing network, and to mark unmarked settlements if you see any. So let's find a place where we can mark road as well as settlement. Yes, okay. Good, we found some place. Let's see how this looks in the OpenStreetMap. Okay, it's already kind of the road and all is marked. So okay, let's skip that. Let's look for something else. Actually, let's try. Okay, so this place looks relatively empty. Okay, yeah. Oh, sorry. Yeah, even this place is good. Actually, let's take this. Okay, sure. So let's start mapping over here. Now there are some instructions and all. I'm gonna skip by to the ID. Okay, the ID editor is a default web-based, browser-based editor. We press start editor. It opens a new window now. Like, it opens a new tab. It loads up OpenStreetMap, the original website, and in the editor mode. So just give it a few seconds for everything to load. Now the imagery has loaded. So this the pink box is our kind of Lakshman Rekha, that you can go out a little bit of it, but not too much. We can see there is already a kind of highway marked, a tertiary road passing through this area, but there is no other marking on this area. So we should add a point here and just mark this as a village. Okay. You can always search over there. For me, I have just marked these things that therefore they're on top. We can see that there is this pretty significant road that's getting out from here and going out there. There are roads inside this settlement, inside connecting. So let's start marking line. You can click and you can even press spacebar to mark your things on the mouse. I find that very useful, the spacebar pressing. So once I've clicked somewhere, I've started drawing a road, I just press space. And I recommend you use a mouse, like, instead of a touchpad on laptop, because the mouse will give you much more, much better accuracy. Okay, this is a nice curve over here. Let's just end the road here because I'm not certain whether this part is a road or not. There's nothing ahead. Now this is a line, I have to mark it as a road. And minor or unclassified road is our favorite road over here. For rural areas, it's always better just to take the option of minor / unclassified road. There are several other things that you can mark here, but let's just go ahead right now. Okay, and let's mark another road here. Space. Also, when you're supposing you'd made a mistake, this is wrong, I've gone wrong somewhere, what do I do? Do not press escape anything. You can press the undo button here or press Ctrl Z on the keyboard, and it will only remove your last point. So you can keep pressing Ctrl Z and your last points will get removed. And Ctrl Shift Z should, okay, whatever. Yeah, so you can just remove just the last mistake you made by just pressing Ctrl Z. So don't worry, don't panic about it, it's all fine. There's always an undo button. And here you want to end it. So to end it, I first have to add the dot. Okay, so I've added the dot. Now I don't want to go ahead, So I press, without clicking anything, I press the enter button on the keyboard, and that ends the mapping. Now the line has been made. I should mark it as a minor unclassified road again. And so this is done. There seems to be a road here, but I don't want to get into that now. We've already pretty much connected this place. There seems to be a road going around this, which is useful. Let's go around, 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 and through, and through, and let's go like that. Right? How is that? Oh wow, it goes out. Let's cut across the tree line over here. It's wonderful to see these big trees around the place. Oh, this road is a bit winding. Let me undo and try to make sure I follow the road accurately. See that? Right. Okay. Now I don't know where this will lead out, but I don't want to go too much out of my boundary. So, pin boundary. So I'm just going to press enter and mark it and leave it there. Also, it might just be turning into a track road, dirt track road. Yeah, it is actually. Actually, it is. So I shouldn't. I think I should just maybe. Okay. I'm just selecting one point over there with the mouse, and then I'm pressing the delete button on the keyboard, and that is getting rid of that point, but keeping the rest of the road. So it might be useful to do that until I think that it's safe to wait. Now undo means restoring it. Let me just end it here. Okay, yeah, that's it. Done. Okay, this road is done. It was going ahead here. Yeah. There's a curve, but I can see just between the tree tops. And you see that? Do you see what I see? Do you? What is this? Something worth investigating. Now, this, just because you see a line drawn over here, that does not mean it's necessarily a road, okay? Just be warned. It could very well just be actually a canal that is dried up right now. So we should look around for other markers, other signs and evidence. Okay, now it doesn't look like it's a canal over here. Over here it actually looks like it's tarred. And then if you just carry, see, you can see that it's kind of tarred. And then if you carry on, then yeah, so it's a road. Okay, it's not a canal, it's a road. So great, we've got a good job ahead in front of us. But this part, it looks more like a, I don't know, it looks like a dirt track. But it's still connecting here to there. I think vehicles can operate on it, so we should do it. And see it, it intersects with the existing road over there. So let's actually just start a little bit outside. And this is why I call this boundary like a Lakshman Rekha, and with some twist to it, that you can go a little bit outside it, don't go too much. It's not strict. You don't have to like extremely just end at the exact edge and everything. Don't worry about that. But yeah, if you're working in a group and you and your teammates are all working on these tasks and somebody else has taken something beside you, then be careful about that. Don't go too much into somebody else's tasks territory. Focus on your thing. Why? Because what they add might not get added to the main, like the master database. It might take some time to make its way through. So you might not be able to see that they have just added a road already, and you might just go into their box and go ahead and add another road over there on top, which is then double mapping, which is bad, let's not do that. So in that case, just try to only cover your part. So we've met the other boundary now, and let's see, what is this? Minor unclassified road crosses minor unclassified road. Where is this? What did I do wrong? I did not hit the point over there. Okay, what can I do over here? Right click, continue, connect, disconnect, split. Wait a sec. Okay, it's connected now. So if you try to move it, we can see that it's connected. So that's good. Now there's no error. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that was my mistake. I had not clicked exactly on this point. I had kind of crossed over, and so it was like a case of one road crossing the other without actually intersecting. These intersecting nodes are very important, because when you have a routing algorithm and stuff, it needs to know that these things are intersecting. If you have them crossing over each other, it will think that they are crossing over each other, like a bridge or something like that. It's not going to then, you know, do the directions properly. Let's connect these two together. Seems like a viable shortcut, although it does also seem like okay, dirt track. So let's just call it for what it looks like. Pretty wide though. That's what, dirt tracks are usually very thin. This is wide, and the way it's like flowing, it feels, got the feel of a canal or something. So it could be that this place, this thing doubles up as a dirt track in the dry season, and it doubles up as a, like, maybe there's water flowing through this in the wet season. It could also be like that. For now, let's just do it like that. Let's look at the rest of our box. What else do we have? Here it really looks like, okay, dirt tracks as well as something flowing, flowy. Not any big settlement going that way as such, so I'm not very motivated to try to map that. There's something here though. What is that? No, okay, it's even just a track again. So I don't want to go behind tracks a lot. Okay, that looks like a well. Okay, extra thing, let's just mark a well. Not an oil well, it's a water well. Right. Okay, something extra, not very important. In this task, we just want to make sure, first of all, we do the roads, and secondary priority is, if you see a human settlement, at least just mark it with a point as a village or a hamlet. Just mark it as a village or a hamlet, so that later on, when other mappers who are like other more experienced mappers who want to properly mark all the buildings and all, and properly mark places, name locations, they can find you. If you have tagged this place, then they will be able to run a search on the database and find out that, okay, there is a village that is tagged, like marked here, but there is nothing else big around it. There's no name to the village, and so let us go over there and try and mark things out. So it's important for us just to, if you see a human settlement, mark it. So let's look at our box again. It's a pretty good job done. I'm satisfied. Let me now save everything to the database. Review your changes and upload them to OpenStreetMap. Change set comment. Okay, leave everything as it is. What is this? Tertiary road crosses canal. Okay, let's see this. I'll just pause the video for a bit and get back to it. Hello everyone. Yeah, I just had another call coming, so I just interrupted. I hope the video resumed properly. So now I found out what the source of the problem was. Our box is here. See, our area is on this side, but somewhere outside of it, the road has been drawn crossing a certain canal or something, and it has not been marked as a bridge over here. And that's a problem. Connect using a ford. What's connect using a ford? Oh, so a ford means a place that you can, the water is crossing the road, but you can also just walk across it. So a place you can walk across the water, but that might not be accurate here. The water might be going under it. So let's undo that. And let's, we have a way of marking a bridge or something. And the way, I'll show you how to do that. So you take a node on the road and split. So you split the line into two parts. So now this is one line and this is another line, right? Now you take another road, the other node also, split that, right? And so now we have one road, another road, and one part that we can call a bridge. So let's call this a bridge embankment. I don't know what's in it. What makes something an embankment as such? I'm not really sure. Okay, yeah, there's an error there, so we should not call it. Let's call it a bridge. Okay, so yeah, so it's the same road, but it turns into a bridge over here, and then it goes on ahead. Like the bridge tag is just added, and that solves our problem. And so now our mapping is done. We still have to upload everything, remember? So okay, everything there, no problem. Upload. And it's by loading. Yep, our changes are done. So now I can close this tab and return to the previous tab where I had pressed start editor. And now the below this, if you see the task things are there, we can just mark it as completely mapped. If there were any untoward things you experience in there, or some really significant thing that you notice or something, write a comment over here and then mark it. In case you are not able to finish mapping the whole thing, do not press the blue button, just press the gray button, the stop mapping button. Write a comment, I did 50%. And I will resume. Someone will have to resume it later. Someone will have to take over from me, or I will come back later for this or whatever. So you can now just, for us, we've done the whole thing. So we mark it as completely mapped. And yep, that's it. Our task here is done. And so now we can take another task. We can pick any other task over here. So I've done two such tasks here. One was a dry run and one with you guys. And yeah, that's it. So do come to here. I mean, I'll put the link in the video description, so you can also come and join me over here. And see you soon. Bye.